definition of connectionless service. So a connectionless service is a technique that is used in data communications to send or transfer data or message at layer 4, that is transport layer. So this is the connectionless service is one of the service or one of the technique which is used in the transport layer. So the transport layer is the fourth layer in the OSI reference model. That means above to the network layer, this transport layer is existed. So the transport layer's duty is this connectionless service. What is this connectionless service? Simply means that the node can transfer or send data packets or messages to its receiver even without session connection to receiver. That means if sender A is there and receiver B is there, so there is no session connection between this A and B. Even though the receiver B is ready to receive the data or not, the sender will transmit the data itself. That means it is not bothering about the receiver, whether the receiver is ready to accept the message or not. Simply, the sender will start transmitting the data packets to the receiver. That's why this connectionless service means there is no logical connection or there is no link between the sender and the receiver. That means the receiver is not ready. Means whether the receiver is existing or not, whether the receiver is ready to accept the data or not. So the sender will not bother about anything. Simply, the sender will transmit the data to the receiver. Message is sent or transferred without prior arrangement. Means there is no prior arrangement between the sender and receiver. That means the sender is not introduced himself to the receiver. That means there is no logical connection between the sender and the receiver. Simply the message, whatever the message is ready with the sender, it will start transmitting that packet to the receiver itself. So here we consider one example. So this is the implementation of connectionless service. Suppose here if you consider two processes are there. One is process P1 and the other one is process P2. So here process P1 is nothing but the sender and process P2 is nothing but the receiver. So now the process P1 is located in host H1 and the process P2 is located in host H2. Here what will happen mean the message means the process P1 hands the message to the transport layer with instructions to deliver to the process P2. That means the process P1 means host H1 is the source node and it is ready to deliver the message to the process P2, which is located in the host H2. Now what it will do? By using the instructions of the transport layer, it will start transmitting the data to the process P2, which is located on the H2. Now the transport layer code runs on this host H1 because each and every host maintains all the layers instructions. That means physical layer instructions, data link layer, network layer, so everything. So here once the process P1 starts transmitting, simply the transport layer code runs in this host H1 and it prepends a transport layer. That means while transmitting the data, so whatever the data is there, so for the data it will prepare header. Means whatever the data is there, for that data it will add or it will append the header. Header means the address of the receiver source, means that is the destination source address is added to the data and it is given to the network layer. Means once in the transport layer, whatever the data is there, for the data means in transport layer, the data is in the form of datagram, right? So the presentation in means what is the presentation of data in transport layer is, it is in the form of datagram. So for that datagram, it will add the address of the destination and it will transmit the data to the network layer. So what is the network layer's duty here? So the network layer's duty is the corresponding node, corresponding data is received by the router and in that router, it will decide to which node the data, means to which nearest node the data will be transmitted. So like that, it will transmit to the nearest node. From that nearest node, again it will transmit it to the next nearest node. So like that, each and every node will transmit the packet until it reaches to the destination. So the same procedure called store and forward packeting packet switching method is applied in each and every case. So if you apply here, the process P1 is located in host H1 and process P2 is located in host H2. In between these processes, we have a subnet is there. So this is called as subnet. So this subnet consisting of six routers. So what are the six routers here? A, B, C, D, E and F. So these are the six routers which are existing as an intermediate nodes between the host H1 and host H2. In this, each of the data packet has source or destination address and is routed one at a time in source node to the destination node. Means whatever the packet, means here host H1 starts transmitting the packet. So that packet is reached to the nearest router first. So from that nearest router, it will transmit to the next router. So like that, each and every packet is transmitted. Here 1, 2, so this 1, 2, 3 and 4 represents the sequence of packets. So how it will reach to the destination node? How it will reach to the destination node? Mean here it will, each and every router maintains a routing table. Because for the best path, for selecting the best path, it will maintain the table that consisting of the root path. So here we have four different tables are there. First one is A's table. That means the router A stable initially and later it will transmit it to. Means how the data is transmitted from one router to the another router. That will be maintained in the router table. And the third one is C table and the last one is E table, because here the packet is transmitted in one direction only. That may be considered like this, means A to B, B to D, D to E, and finally it will reach us to F. This is one path. Another path is A to C, C to D, D to E, and E to F. That is also one path. And the final one is A to C, C to E, and E to F. So this is one path. So we have n number of different paths are there. So from this n number of paths, we will choose, mean the routers will choose the best path. For that, choosing the best path, it will maintain the routing table. So how it will maintain the routing table? Mean, consider the first one, A's table initially. So how it will be the routing table will be. So here we have two columns are there. One is destination, another one is line. Line means in which, means the previous nearest node. So what is the nearest node? In which line it is passing. So here A's table. So A's table means A is the main router. It will maintain the routing table. So how it will maintain the routing table? We have six routers are there. For the six routers, how it will move from one node to the another node? For example, if A is the source and B is the destination, second case, if B is the destination, so there is a direct link between source A and B. So that's why there is no intermediate node between this one. So directly the line B is used for reaching to the B. So for example, if you consider the C, third case, C. So there is a direct link between the source A and source C. So the directly A will transmit packet to C. This is one path. And for example, if you consider the destination as D. So how many routes are there for reaching to D? A to B and B to D. That is one line. A to C and C to D. That is one line. So for example, if you consider A to B and from B to D. So that's why D is the destination and we will consider the line is B. That means A to B and from B to D the data packet is transmitted. That is one existing route path. And if you consider E, E is the destination. So if you consider E is the destination, again here we have so many paths are there. A to B, B to D and D to E, that is one line. Our other line is A to C, C to E. So now for passing through the line of B, we will cross two different intermediate nodes, that is B and D. But for simplification, for the shortest path, we will move to C and C to E. This is the best path. So that's why here if you consider E is the destination, then we will choose the path that is C. C here. And next for F means for destination F, we will choose the line that is C. This is one path. So like this, the routers, each and every routers maintain the packet, routing packets means that that is nothing but routers line in which direction we are passing to the destination and which direction it is moved from one source to the destination source. So each and every routing table maintains two columns. One is the destination router and the other one is called as in which line it is passing. So in which line means we have two different, means n number of different lines are there. So from that n number of lines, initially from starting position, from A, it will choose which direction that will be mentioned in the routing table. So like this, we will write the A's table later, means final A's table and C table and router E table. So like that, each and every router will maintain the routing table. Whenever the packet is received to the particular router, it will maintain the routing table, and by using that routing table, it will pass that packet to the next node. So for that purpose, each and every router maintains the routing table. So like this, the process P1 will transmit the packet to the process P2. So here if we observe that while transmitting the packet from source to destination, there is no bothering about the receiver node. That means whether the receiver is ready to accept the data or not ready to accept the data. And another case is, even though the receiver is existing or not also, we don't know. Sometimes the receiver node is corrupted or there is no existence of the receiver node. That time also, the sender is not bothering about the receiver, simply transmitting the packet. That is the connectionless service. Clear? So connectionless means there is no session link between the source and destination. There is no pre-arrangement between the source and destination. The source will decide to transmit the packet. So that's why this is, the source will not bothering about the receiver, whether it is receiving the data or not. Simply it will transmit the packet. So here the data packets follow different paths to reach the destination. So like that, here from source process P1 to process P2, we have n number of paths are there. So it will choose any path, and that path must be shortest path, because for optimal transmission of the data packet, it will choose the best path. And the main important thing is the data is sent in one direction from source to destination without checking whether the receiver is ready to accept message or not. Simply, it will choose the best path, it will choose the next node, and it will transmit the packet. So, the implementation of connectionless service is the real-time example. We will consider the postal departments, means postal services. So, if you consider the postal service, in that also, there is no specific connection between the source and destination. Simply, the sender wants to send a message to the receiver. So he will write a letter. On that letter, he will write the from address and to address. Simply post that card. Even though the receiver, means who are the receiver, is available or not, that is not bothered by the sender. He simply post the letter. So the duty of the postman will transfer that message to the receiver. So sometimes there may be a possibility that the receiver is not available in that particular address, because the receiver will change its address, or the receiver will went to some other place. So like that, cases also happen. But the sender is not bother about that receiver itself. Simply, he is sending the message. So that is the best and real-time example for connectionless service. So for implementing this connectionless service, we will follow so many protocols, different type of protocols also there. So what are the different type of protocols? First one is allow data to be transferred without any connection among the processes. So in this connectionless service, the data transfer will be done without any pre-arrangement. So there is no pre-arrangement between the source and the destination. So without any connection only, the sender will transmit the data, and if the receiver is ready to accept, he receives the data. Otherwise, the data is not received to the receiver also. Some of the data packets may also be lost during transmission. So here there is no pre-arrangement is there. So that's why sometimes the packets may lost during the transmission also. So even though the packet is lost, that will not be intimated to the sender, because there is no understanding between the sender and the receiver. So there is no acknowledgement case. So if acknowledgement is not there, then the sender's duty is just sending the data. Even it is received by the receiver, or even it is lost in the during the transmission, anything will happen, but that is not bothered by the sender. So some of the protocols for connectionless services are, four different protocols are there. One is internet protocol, that is IP protocol. So what is this IP protocol? So IP protocol is used to create the packet. This is the IP protocol is one of the protocol used in the network layer. So this IP protocol is working based on the connectionless service only. Mean there is no pre-arrangement by using this IP protocol. What is the main motto of this IP protocol? To make it a packets, whatever the data is received from the transport layer, that will be make it into a IP packet. So what is IP packet? It consisting of address called header and data. So that data is nothing but the payload, header is nothing but the address of the destination node. So to make it into an IP packet, the internet protocol, the protocol is used in the network layer. Next one is user datagram protocol, UDP. UDP, user datagram protocol. So this UDP is the transport layers protocol. This is also working under the connectionless service only. So here also the source will simply transmit the data without pre-arrangement of the session connection between the source and the destination. So that's why UDP protocol is also one of the example of the connectionless service. And the next one is Internet Control of Message protocol. So this is ICMP. So ICMP is also working based on the connectionless service only. Here also there is no connection establishment between the sender and the receiver. Simply transmitting the packets. That's it. And the next one is Internetwork Packet Exchange. This is IPX. So IPX is the short form for Internetwork Packet Exchange. So this Internetwork Packet Exchange is also a connectionless protocol. So these are all the four different protocols which works under the connectionless service. That means there is no pre-arrangement, there is no connection establishment between the source and the receiver. Simply the source, if the source wants to transmit, so simply it will start transmitting the packet itself. Even though the packet is received or the packet is lost, anything will happen during the transmission. But the sender will not bother about the receiver. Simply, it will transmit the packets. So, in implementation of connectionless service, it will have a different type of services are there. So, what are the different type of services mean? Unreliable datagram. So, here the first case, the first service is unreliable datagram. So, why it is datagram? From a transport layer to the network layer, the data is in the form of datagrams. So whatever the datagram, whatever the data transmitted from the sender, that will be unreliable, because there is no establishment between the connection establishment between the sender and the receiver. So that's why who sent the data, even though the receiver is ready to accept or not, that will not be bothered. So that's why whatever the datagram transmitted by the sender, that will be unreliable only, not a reliable one. So the example for this unreliable datagram is electronic junk mails. So electronic junk mails are the example, the best examples for this unreliable datagram. So in our electronic emails, we have a spam is there. So what is that spam? So we don't have a connection. We don't know who is the sender. Even though we don't know the sender reliably, the sender will transmit the packets. The packets is nothing but emails to us. So that junk files, that junk mails are the examples for this unreliable datagrams. So because there is no connection between the sender and the receiver for junk for receiving the junk mails. So spams, best examples are spam mails. So second one is acknowledged datagram. So what is acknowledged datagram? Once the sender will send the datagram, that is received by the receiver. If the datagram is correctly received by the receiver, simply the receiver will send the acknowledgement, the receiving message. Means once he accepted the message, simply he will send the message. I accepted the message or I received the message. That is called as acknowledgement. So even though the acknowledgement is of two types, either positive acknowledgement or negative acknowledgement. So acknowledged datagram. The best example for this one is registered mail, text messages along with delivery report, etc. So these two are the examples. So registered mail. For example, I want to transmit a mail to a particular person. So what I will do? I will send a mail and make a call and tell I sent a mail. Please check once. Otherwise, if a person who is a sender, means who sent a mail to you, if you receive that one, definitely you will send a reply message to that person. If the sender is known to you, that means there is a pre-arrangement or connection establishment between the sender and the receiver. Once the receiver will receive a mail, then automatically he will send a reply message to that particular sender. So that's why the registered mail is one of the example for acknowledged datagram. And the second one is text messages. So if you send a text message through a mobile phone, then once it is received by the receiver, you receives an acknowledgement, right? Message received by person number time. So that will be received, that will be acknowledged to you by the network service provider itself. Sometimes the receiver also send a reply message to you. Whatever the message you send, so according to that message, the receiver will send a reply message. So for each and every text message, we receive a delivery report. That delivery report is nothing but the acknowledgement datagram. So while sending the mail also, we receive a delivery report. What is that delivery report? Mail sent. So while it is sending process, it will show the acknowledgement as sending dot dot dot. So once the message is sent, so simply it will acknowledged, it will send the delivery report as message sent, right? So third one is request reply. So this is also one of the service of connectionless services. So what is this request reply means? Queries from remote databases. That means if you are using a client server architecture. So client server architecture means the client will send a request to the receiver. So receiver is nothing but the server. So once the request is received by the server, simply it will send the reply message. That is called as response. So that request and response type messages are called as request reply. So queries from remote databases. So that is the best example for request reply. So these are the three different services provided in connectionless services. So connectionless service is implemented in the transport layer. So in that transport layer, these are the three different services. Now coming to the advantages. So what are the main advantages of this connectionless service? So it is very fast and also allows for multicast and broadcast operations. So very fast, because there is no pre-arrangement of connection. So simply, if the sender wants to transmit, if pre-arrangement is required, what will happen? The sender will send a request to the receiver. So the receiver will accept that request. So it will take some time for acceptance of the request. So once it accepts the request, then the connection is established. So after establishment of the connection only, the data will transmit. So it is a slow process. That's why the connectionless service is, there is no establishment, there is no pre-arrangement between the sender and the receiver. Simply the sender is having the message, simply he starts transmitting the message itself. So that's why it is a very fast and also allows for multicast and broadcast. What is multicast and broadcast? At a time, we are sending a single message to n number of devices. So single message to n number of devices, that is called as multicast and broadcast. So by using this connectionless service, this multicast and broadcast messages are possible. So this is the main one of the advantages of this connectionless service. This service is very easy and simple. Very easy, because there is no establishment of connection. Simply, if the sender wants to transmit, he will transmit. That's why it is very easy and simple. At the network layer, host software is very much simpler. So at the network layer, because the connectionless service is the transport layer's service, transport layer's duty. So it will transmit the packet to the network layer. So at network layer, the host is located. So that host software is very much easier, because easily it will transmit the packets. There is no there is no connections are required. So simply it will start transmitting the packets. No authentication is required in this service. So this is a connectionless. So connectionless means there is no pre-arrangement between the sender and the receiver. So the sender's duty is simply he is transmitting the data, and he is not expecting for any acknowledgement from the receiver. He is not expecting any delivery report. That's why no authentication is required in this service. Some of the applications doesn't even require sequential delivery of packets or data. So sometimes does not even require a sequential delivery of packets or data. What is sequence delivery of packet? One after the another. So all the packets are not transmitted at a time. So sequentially we will transmit the packets. So those packets are delivered. Means some of the application does not even require this sequential delivery of the packets. Sometimes randomly the packets are delivered, because there is no establishment, right? So due to the delay of the propagation delay, sometimes one packet one is received at a time, and after some time the packet two will receive. So like that, it will not followed any sequential manner. So now coming to the disadvantages. So the service is less reliable as compared to the connection oriented service. Yes, this is very less reliable, because there is no establishment of connection between the sender and the receiver. So the sender sometimes may be authorized one, sometimes not an unauthorized persons also will send the data. So spam is one of the example for that one, because sometimes we will receive a message from the unauthorized persons. That's why this connectionless service is less reliable as compared to the connection oriented service. It does not guarantee that there will be no loss or error occurrence, missed delivery, duplication, or out of sequence delivery of the packet. So any of the cases not guaranteed in this connectionless service, because the sender's duty is just transmitting the packet. That's it. So once he put the packet in the channel, he is not bothering about whether it is received by the receiver, whether any errors are occurred, whether the data is lost, any case. So there is no guarantee for these ones. So the loss of data, error occurrence, or missed delivery, duplication. So all these things are not considered in case of connectionless services. So this is about implementation of connectionless service. So in the next, we will see what is the implementation of connection-oriented service.